Good day everyone, welcome back to our YouTube channel, and today I'm going to be giving you guys tips for what to consider when hiring an attorney. What is a lawyer, their obligations towards citizens, their duties, and just how you go about hiring an attorney. So the term lawyer is generally used by everyone, however it is a term used to refer to all legal professionals. So not all attorneys are lawyers. For example, a lawyer is anyone who has been trained in law or has a bachelor's of law degree. An attorney, on the other hand, is someone who attained their bachelor's of law degree, their LLB degree, completed 2 years of articles, written their board exams, and attended a practical legal course. This is known as law school in South Africa. So all attorneys can be referred to as lawyers, but not all lawyers can be referred to as attorneys. So what obligations does an attorney have towards citizens? There are provisions to hold attorneys accountable and further the interests of their clients to adequate and competent representation. So the number of professional negligence claims against legal practitioners has increased considerably over the past few years. So allegations of unprofessional conduct on part of legal practitioners can negatively affect the public's perception of the profession. Therefore, every practitioner is bound by the profession to ensure that their duties are discharged in a good faith and good manner. So the attorneys have many duties, such as, first of all, legal professional privilege and confidentiality. Attorneys must not disclose any form of communication or reveal the contents of the documents provided by the client without the client's consent. However, in order for legal privilege to apply, there are four requirements that needs to be present. Firstly, the attorney must have acted in his professional capacity. He must have been at work, for example, at his workplace. Secondly, the client must have consulted with the attorney in confidence, so not in a space of, for example, at a braai. Understand? So also the third part is that the communication must have been made for the purpose of obtaining legal advice. Lastly, the advice must not facilitate the commission of a crime such as fraud or murder, etc. Attorneys also has responsibility to uphold the interests of the client at all given times and to render proper accounts of services to the client or statement of account. So complaints about a legal practitioner, where do you complain when you are unhappy with your attorney or the services rendered by your attorney? So the legal profession is governed by the Legal Practice Act, which used to be the Attorneys Act. And in terms of this act, all legal practitioners fall under a regulatory body known as the Legal Practice Council. And also it was known as the Law Society, also most commonly known as the Law Society of South Africa. The Legal Practice Council has a duty to act in public interest and has to protect the public against unprofessional and irresponsible conduct by legal practitioners. The client needs to lodge a complaint against the attorney by the relevant legal practice office. So you have offices in all provinces. So obviously it will be in the province where the attorney executes his work. So what happens when an attorney improperly handles a case? An attorney is required to communicate the progress of the case to his client at all times. If an attorney fails to act diligently, it can lead to the client's case being dismissed. The client can then take action against the attorney for negligence. If an attorney promises to win a case and then fails, what happens then? An attorney should always be honest with the client and avoid misleading the client at all costs. However, sometimes no matter how good the attorney is, there is a possibility of the case being dismissed or not being successful. If there's a conflict of interest, what happens then? So what is conflict of interest? This is a situation that hinders an attorney's ability to provide his or her client with undivided loyalty and attention. So an attorney should also be careful when representing two or more clients at once. An attorney cannot represent another client who has similar interests to his client. If an attorney finds himself in this position, they cannot proceed and they cannot act on behalf of that client. This rule does protect the client from potential biasness by the attorney who may favor the other clients. And if a client finds him or herself in a situation like this, he or she can terminate his or her mandate with such attorney. Or if this client discovers this later on, he or she can take legal action against the attorney. What is a client attorney client privilege? An attorney cannot make this information of the client or the case public that falls within the client's privilege rules. There is, however, exceptions to this rule. For example, if the client commits a crime, so the attorney has an obligation towards the court to always disclose the truth and not to mislead the court. If the client is of the view that the attorney broke this attorney-client rule, he or she can lodge a complaint against the attorney with the legal practice counsel. So can an attorney hold documents in lien? Lien is security over documents. So an attorney has the right to retain a client's file for as long as their account has not been fully paid. Attorneys are entitled to charge interest on amounts outstanding or exercise a lien over any documents or monies they possess for unpaid bills. This is, for example, letters addressed to the attorney by clients. Once the account is paid, the attorney must hand over the file. Where the attorney overcharges the client, what happens then? The attorney must prepare a statement of account regularly, which lists the item the client is charged for, has a description and dates and times of this item. Fees charged must be in accordance with prescribed fees that is prescribed by the legal practice counsel, and the statement of account then gets texted by the texting master, who is an employee of the court. There's a texting master in every court, whether it be the high court, the magistrate's court, the regional court, etc. There's always a texting master. To text a bill entails that you as the client and the attorney argues the items in front of the texting master, and the texting master then makes the final decision. Should the client still not be satisfied with the texting master's decision, he or she can withhold payment and the attorney will then issue summons against this client. The client must, however, have sufficient proof, as the court is always reluctant to rule against the attorney's statement of account. A client should also always be mindful that there are many situations where an attorney receives a negative result despite his or her best efforts. So the attorney is still obligated to charge you even if the case was not successful. So what happens if you cannot afford an attorney? You have legal aid in South Africa for the destitute people of the country. The LPC, or the Legal Practice Council, can also appoint an attorney to assist you on a pro bono basis, provided that you comply with a means test. A means test is where they look at your salary and your expenditure and then what's left after all that. So then you need to comply with a certain percentage. So you also only pay, if you do get an attorney on a pro bono matter, you only pay the expenses such as sheriff fees, and you do not pay for the legal services provided. To get pro bono assistance, you can visit the Legal Practice Council's website and fill out an application form, or you can go to their offices. And I also know in court there is a legal aid assistance office. So in conclusion, you are the one always giving instructions to the attorney and can always terminate your mandate with the attorney at any time if you are unhappy. An attorney cannot act without your instructions, and attorneys must always give you clear, accurate, and honest advice. If you guys have enjoyed watching this legal tutorial, if I might add, please like and subscribe this video, and please like this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel, and then also click on the bell notification button to get more notifications for more videos.